This is Real Madrid for IFL TV, proudly sponsored by Everlast. What a night in New York. I'm joined by Lou DiBella, George Kambosos Jr., creating history for Australia, Greece, and himself.
Yeah, he did, but I told you, actually, a long time ago, over a year ago, when this fight was first being conceived as a mandatory, when after we had a conversation, you probably don't remember this, after Kambosos beat Selby. And I said, when this fight happened, it would be a fight. And what he did tonight, the brilliance of his performance can't be underestimated. I mean, he took an all-New York crowd for a kid from Brooklyn, an undisputed young champion that everyone had in the pound-for-pound list. And I thought, honestly, he in a lot of times in that fight, dominated and made him look silly. And it was a good fight. I mean, Lopez came on in some of those sort of mid-late rounds. As soon as it became clear that the fight was tightening up, Kambosos turned it around again and came out in the 11th and 12th and fought his ass off and was brilliant. A long time ago, Peter Kahn brought me this little kid, tatted up kid, Greek kid from Australia, and said, take a look at this kid, he can really fight. And the kid's father said to me, my son's a world champion. And no one wanted to sign him and no one believed in him, but he believed in himself. I mean, it's a Rocky story. It's an underdog story. And he's a hell of a fighter, and he's a young fighter. You know, I mean, he belongs in, there are no, if you're gonna start talking about kings of lightweight, well, there are five of them.
What were you thinking after kind of first 2.5 minutes of the first round?
I wasn't shocked that Lopez got caught. And I'll tell you, because I knew Lopez, there was so much bad feeling, and Lopez was the bigger, stronger guy. People thought going in, at least Lopez thought. So I knew Lopez would be trying to rough George up early and going after a knockdown. Like, I thought that was going to be what he was going to do. He was going to bum rush Kambosos. But when you're that intent on offense and you're bum rushing somebody, what do? You leave yourself open. When you're fighting a world-class, true championship-level fighter, which George Kambosos is, you're leaving yourself open to be put down. And Lopez got put down.
Absolutely. Got hurt towards, I think, the 10th round. George, he got dropped, but recovered fairly well, looked composed.
Look, he took some bombs, man. He took some bombs, and he showed a chin on top of everything else. Look, it was almost a complete performance. He showed every element of the game. He showed offense. He showed defense. His was the more active jab. His was the better. He boxed the better fight. And then in terms of chin, Lopez landed some absolute bombs. And surviving that round where he got hurt, that showed a tremendous chin. The kid has a lot of resolve. He describes himself as a Spartan warrior. He is a Spartan warrior.
What did you make of Teofimo Lopez then? He won that fight 10 rounds to 2.
He's wrong, but I love Lopez. I think he's a hell of a fighter. He lost the fight, but I thought it was by a couple of points. I thought that George had a bigger lead, and then Lopez cut into that lead, and in the last couple of rounds, George turned it right around back to his favor and fought his fight. Look, it was an overall brilliant night.
I've heard the name Devin Haney several times.
You could hear the name every time you want, but of course Devin Haney's a possible big fight, but so there are a lot of them. I mean, this is the biggest name now. He's the guy between 30 and 40. He's sitting there at 35 with all these belts. He's the man. He's going to decide what he wants to do, what's best for him. I'm going to present him with every opportunity that's out there. Haney's obviously a possibility. But we're going to look at all alternatives and where this is prize fighting. So we're going to find out where the biggest prizes are and what the best game plan is for Kambosos. And ultimately, he's the man now, and he's going to be making the decisions in charge of his own destiny in terms of what direction he goes in when he looks at all alternatives.
Possibly headlining the card in Australia as well?
Absolutely. Possibility, sure. And absolutely a possibility.
Listen, congratulations on the win, Lou.
Thank you very much.
A fantastic night in the garden. And George Kambosos Jr. certainly put himself as one of the stars in boxing today.
Well, you saw the whole promotion. He carried the promotion with Teofimo. And honestly, it was George's confidence. George was in Cam Lopez's head a little bit, but it was more George's own head. Like, George walked in tonight believing he was going to win. He walked in that ring tonight with a purpose and a plan, and he executed it. And he didn't have one iota of doubt that he was going to walk away with those belts. It's all he said since this fight was conceived, was that he was going to beat this guy and he was going to walk away with all those belts. And he did. I mean, that's remarkable.
Thank you, Luke.
Thank you.